Our story begins before the world was formed. Now that's a good story.
And it has lots of different people in it. Mary, Joseph, Jesus, Isaiah, Micah, Gabriel, Simeon.
Wait a minute, I thought this was a Christmas story. I know Mary, Joseph, and Jesus are in the Christmas story, but who are all those other people?
This is the Christmas story, but we're starting the story way before Mary and Joseph. We're starting hundreds of years before the Isaiah the prophet. He had a few things to say about the coming Messiah.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Getting better and better.
to Gad and Judah, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David.
That sounds familiar. Didn't Mary and Joseph go there to be counted?
Yes, but years before Caesar Augustus ordered that census, a prophet named Micah foretold that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. But you, Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come from me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from old, from ancient times.
So Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem, and while they were there, it was time for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son.
This is my favorite part.
Thank you.
someone named Simeon. Was he a shepherd?
No, Simeon's not a shepherd, but it is time to tell about the shepherds. There were shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over near their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that is for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angels praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to man on whom his favor rests."
Thank you.
wise men?
Well, I guess you could say Simeon was a wise man, but not one of those ones who visited Jesus with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. He was a wise man because he was a righteous and devout man of God. He met baby Jesus when he was just 8 days old at the temple in Jerusalem.
You see, Simeon had been promised by the Holy Spirit they wouldn't die until they had seen the Messiah. When he saw Jesus, he took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you promised, you now dismiss your servants in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel."
I get it. This, the light of revelation that Simon talked about, is for us. It's Jesus. He is our salvation. That's why he was born.
Ethan, Shalaya. That was awesome. Every year at this